Hey guys, it's Vero, welcome back to my channel. We are about to convert our van for a living and I would like to share the conversion with you. So this is our van. It's Ford Transit and we just recently bought it, so it's already ours. And we started a few days ago with removing the floor. It was such a pain because there were really big screws. We used a hot glue to hide the holes. We would like to start with the floor today, but probably it will take longer than only one day. So I will take you through the whole process of doing the floor and we will see how long it will take. As a first step, before we will start with the actual floor, we need to remove a rust from the van. Fortunately, there are just a few spots which we need to remove, and we will start with using a drill and Mirek 3D printed this brush which we will use. As you can see, here are some spots with the rust. Okay guys, now after I removed the rust, not too much, just a little bit, and just to clean it up, and now I'm going to use this thing. I'm not sure what is it called in English, but basically it should remove the rust for you. So I'm going to apply it with this brush. It's been a few hours since I applied the liquid on the rust, and it started to rain, so the rust will be the only thing we will do today because we can't work outside. So we will continue tomorrow. And as you can see, the rust is already dry and there is like a white on the top, so I guess it's fine now. And I will apply a zinc. It's the next day and we are going to continue with the floor. It's a beautiful day today, so hopefully it will not be raining like yesterday. And we just went to Baumax to buy the tape and we are going to use it for the insulation on the floor. We put together the OSB panels from wood, which is this material. It's 12 millimeters thick and we put on top of the panels our template, and now I'm going to draw where we want to sew it. I'm going to use the zinc on parts of the car. There are some scratches, but there is no rust. So I will cover it with the zinc and then the color. It's the next day and I'm going to continue with the insulation on the floor. I'm not sure if the footage is on the camera, but I showed you yesterday that we put the panels on the floor here and it's fitting perfectly already. And Mirek is impregnating the panels now. The impregnation should keep the wood from the moisture and molds. In the meantime, I'm doing the insulation. Mirek is using this tool.
It's a riveter.
Riveter. Oh wow. This is that hard, Mirek.
It's okay.
So what are you supposed to do?
Me?
Yes.
You mean the tool?
Well, I mean, what are you doing inside? What are you using?
So this is a riveter nut, which allows...
Oh, okay.
Which allows us to put their regular bolts, which means we are able to take them away if we need to, if we need to change something, or if we need to repair something. So that's why we are not using the normal bolts for wood. We are using these.
Okay, cool. Thank you. It's another day and we are continuing with the insulation of the floor. It's taking really long time. We thought that we will be done with the insulation in one day and it's already a third day of insulation and this is how we are continue. We are filling the ribs with the insulation and then we put one layer of the 5 millimeter thick insulation on top of the ribs. Ta-da! The insulation is done already! We taped the insulation together so there are no holes. Even here it's taped. And now we are going to add the wood planks there. Okay guys, the floor is already done. Thank you for watching and see you soon. Bye!